How's it going, everyone? Your boy Corey here, aka Crasher, back with a new video. And ladies and gentlemen, we're gonna be doing something we haven't done in quite some time, and that is a Pokémon Showdown battle narration slash commentary. And in this particular video, we're gonna be doing this for not one, but three battles. That's right, these were done in a best of three series, and these are all gonna be taking place in Generation 8 Double Uber. So you know there's going to be some gargantuan action taking place here. We got my man Grand Empress taking on Evil Frost. Let's let the sparks fly and let's let the battle begin, baby. I cannot wait. Hope you guys enjoy. Let's lock and load and do this. All right, let's let the games begin, ladies and gentlemen. We have ourselves Incineroar and the Magearna leading off, Pokeball Edition, taking on Kingdra, that's shiny, and Kyogre, that's shiny. Ooh, double pink shinies for the win, baby. But we got the Intimidate activating, and oh, Kyogre activates the Dynamax first turn, and we got the Fake Out going on, and we got Muddy Water attacking both Incineroar and the Magearna. But we have the Citrus Berry activating, restoring a bit of Incineroar's health, and we got Max Geyser completely shutting down the Magearna. Oh, man! And it looks like that Fake Out didn't work either because, well, it didn't flinch, obviously. But now we have ourselves Kyogre coming in. Both are shiny in the Hurricane. Not going to do that much damage. And the Thunder, not going to do that much damage despite being super effective against the Dynamax Kyogre. But the Dynamax Kyogre ends up taking down the shiny Kyogre with Max Lightning. And now we got ourselves Parting Shot here. And we have ourselves a bit of a situation. Grand Empress already lost two of his Pokemon, whereas his Pokemon still has all six. But now we have ourselves Melmetal and Kyrex Ice Rider both coming in. And we have ourselves Dynamax coming in. And let's see this. We got Protect now. Oh, man. This is going to be crazy, baby. This is going to be crazy. Muddy Water's not going to really do that much to either of the Pokemon. And Max Geyser is going to do a little bit of damage. But we got Max Quake. And that's going to boost the special defense of both Ice Rider, Calyrex, and Melmetal. And we got Muddy Water once again, not really doing that much damage despite being boosted in Rain. And even Origin Pulse isn't doing that much damage from a freaking Kyogre. But we got ourselves Max Steel Spike, and that is going to take down the Kyogre and boost the defenses. And oh shit, we got Trick Room. And here comes Bacon Bird Eveltal coming in. Buddy. But now we got Protect happening. Let's see what's going to happen now, baby. And the Sucker Punch is not going to work. And Max Lightning, my god, that takes down the Eveltal, just completely destroyed him. And it seems like, it seems like the tides have turned a little bit. But now we have ourselves Regieleki, and that thing is also shiny too. But now we got Body Press on the Kingdra, does nearly half damage. But, Glacial Lance just takes down both the Regieleki and the Kingdra, and Chilling Nay activates, and oh man, that's really, really not good, especially under Trick Room. We got Shadow Rider Calyrex and Xerneas both coming in, but it doesn't look like it's going to be their day. Double Iron Bash. Oh, Calyrex just barely survives, but the Glacial Lance, it finishes off both of the remaining Pokemon, and Grand Empress is the winner of the first match. Holy shit. That is how you make an impact, ladies and gentlemen. But let's see what takes place in battle number two. GG to you both, by the way. That was fan-flippin-tastic. All right, here we go with battle number two with the exact same teams. Let's see if the outcome is going to be the exact same. So we have ourselves Calyrex Shadow Rider and Shiny Bacon Bird leading off from Evil Frost. And we got Zacian leading off and Shiny Kyogre. Here we go, baby. Now things are about to get real. Oh, Eveltal Dynamax first turn. And we got Protect from Calyrex. And let's see what's going to happen. Origin Pulse protected and missed. Oh, man. And Behemoth Blade. Yep, that doesn't do anything either. So it's a complete standstill, and well, that Max Airstream actually did quite a bit of damage and boosts the speed of the opposing Pokemon from Evil Frost. And we got Astral Barrage. Oh my god, that Kyogre just barely lived. Holy shit. And Max Airstream is gonna be enough to take down the Zacian. Okay. Seems like Grand Empress is in a little bit of a pickle here, but can he make a comeback? We did see something like this in the previous battle, but now in comes Melmetal, And we have ourselves Incineroar now making an appearance. And we got the Dynamax happening. Let's see this. We got Astral Barrage. And, well, it's not going to do that much damage. And let's see what's going to happen next, baby. We got Max Darkness. And that doesn't do that much either, but it is gonna lower the special defenses of both Pokemon. But now we got Max Quake, and that's going to reset, so to speak, the special defenses. And Dynamax has worn off from Meveltal. We got Astral Barrage taking place. And again, not really that much damage taking place either. And we got Oblivion Wing, and Incineroar survives. Shipping, no question. Incineroar is fucking goated, man. But now we have ourselves Parting Shot from Incineroar, lowering the offenses of both Pokemon, and in comes Magearna. We got Max Quake to the Calyrex, and that right there finally takes down Calyrex. And we got Soul Heart activating, so Magearna is at plus one in the special attack. And in comes Kyogre, and we got Protect from Magearna. Let's see what's gonna happen, baby. We got ourselves Dark Pulse happening, but to no avail. And Water Spout. But damn, that... I'm telling you, that Melmetal is tough as nails, and wow. But now Dynamax is completely off the table at this point, but in comes Regieleki now, and we have ourselves a switch back into Incineroar, and the Citrus Berry activates, but also Intimidate activates as well. We got Dark Pulse, not really doing that much damage to Magearna, unsurprisingly, and here comes Trick Room. Uh-oh. Oh, here comes Dazzling Creams! That does a ton of damage to both Eveltal and Regieleki, and we have ourselves Parting Shot again! Man, oh man, those offenses are being massacred right now, but in comes Calyrex, Ice Rider, and Reflect from Regieleki, okay! And Dark Pulse with a critical hit, but even still not really doing too much damage. We got Sucker Punch, and... wow, doesn't really do that much damage despite being both super effective. And Glacial Lance takes down Eveltal and Regieleki. And my god, Soul Heart activates as well as Chilling Gneiss. So we got some major offenses being upped big time. But now we have ourselves Kingdra coming in. And we have Xerneas coming in as well. I'm really not liking their chances at this point. Glacial Lance just easily wipes the floor with Kingdra. And Xerneas hangs on with 20% health, but I don't know about this, man. I really, really don't know about this. Like, this is just wow right here. And Evil Frost ends up forfeiting, and Grand Empress takes the W in match number two. And wow, all I can say is that even if Grand Empress appears to be put in a corner, do not count that man out a single bit, because he does have his way with the comebacks. I'll tell you what, man. But with that being said, let's go on now to battle number three. So here we are, battle number three, but we do have ourselves a couple of noticeable changes here. We have ourselves Amoongus and Regieleki now swapped in for Grand Impress. And for Evil Frost, we have ourselves Zapdos and Indeedee. So... let's see if these changes here are perhaps going to make a difference. Let's see here. So let's begin. We have ourselves a battle beginning. We have ourselves Shiny Regieleki and Shiny Amoongus taking the stage versus Indeedee and Shiny Bacon Bird Eveltal. Let's see this. Psychic Surge also activate. Oh! Special defense boost because of the Psychic Seeds, baby. And the Dynamax Eveltal. Here we go. And we got ourselves Follow Me happening. And Volt Switch. Oh! A crit! That does a lot of damage to Indeedee. And here comes Zacian. Oh my god. And the Max Airstream. Oh man, I was slightly hoping Amoongus would have survived that, but alas, it's not to be. Man, that Eveltal is a monster when it's played right, I'm telling you. But now we have ourselves Follow Me again, and Regieleki is back in as well. We have ourselves Electroweb. And it seems like Indeedee just couldn't handle it anymore. We got Behemoth Blade. Oh! Taking down the Eveltal, and wow. I have to say, it looks like Grand Impress is unstoppable, but the battle ain't over yet. We have ourselves Kyogre and Kingdra, double pink shinies, and Protect on the Zacian. And we got Volt Switch, does a ton of damage to Kyogre, and we have ourselves, well, his own Kyogre coming back in, and we have ourselves Muddy Water, not doing that much damage, and Origin Pulse. And it misses completely. So let's see this. Let's see what's gonna happen next, baby. We have Muddy Water yet again hitting both of Grand Impress's Pokemon, but Play Rough hits back, and that Kingdra got clapped big time. But now we got Origin Pulse missing once again, but also ends up hitting the Kyogre. And we got Water Spout, and Kyogre barely survives with 3% health. Oh, man. But now in comes Cantonian Zapdos and Playruff. Yep, goodbye, Zapdos. You didn't have a chance in hell of surviving that. But we now have ourselves Kyogre going down. But even still, it is a 4-2 advantage for Grand Impress. And in comes Calyrex Shadow Rider. And in comes the shiny Regieleki. Woo! Here we go. We have ourselves Electroweb taking down the Kyogre and doing damage to Calyrex while lowering the speed by one stage. And Behemoth Blade slaps Calyrex in the face. And that right there puts the final nail in the coffin in the best of three series, making Grand Impress the 3-0 winner in this. And my God, were these matches ever creamy. I am telling you, they were crisp, like fucking apple crisp, man. Fresh from the oven. Like, it doesn't get any better when it comes to fresh from the oven baked apple crisp. And that is the equivalent of what these battles are, in my opinion. They were fucking apple crisp. Definitely a great game to you both, man. I'm telling you, you both played exceptionally well here. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you guys did, let me know in the comments down below. Thank you guys very much for watching. Thank you for your time. Have yourself a damn good one. And as always, your boy will see you guys in the next video.